noodling around with. For some reason, well, it's May 1st. Happy May Day. And welcome to the second third of the year, I guess. I hope everybody's doing okay locked up where, although I think a lot of things are opening up today. Not so much here in California. Beaches in Orange County just got slammed shut because of kind of abuse by people not really thinking. Anyway, I know things are changing in a few spots, and I hope everybody's still getting some good guitar playing in and getting used to our new lifestyle. So, but what was going on with those songs is, for some reason, I hadn't shown anybody Sounds of Silence in 10 or 15 years. Probably since I did a lesson for it for TG here. And all of a sudden, I had like 6 or 7 students that it was like the perfect thing for them to work on. So right now, I've got about a third of my students are working on Sounds of Silence and... some nice little finger-picking things with Paul Simons. And, he put up another... Well, no, I guess this one was older, too. But I think a few weeks ago, I dug up links to some of the things that he's been doing. His little live versions. There's one of American Tune that one of my students just pointed out the other day, too. Ah! And somebody else just yesterday mentioned another video I got to check out. Don McLean playing Vincent at the Van Gogh Museum in Amsterdam. So, haven't done that yet, but now that I've mentioned it on here, I might remember. That's on my agenda for later today. So the story on Sounds of Silence, yeah, it's just a great little picking exercise for people. Whether you sing it or not, it doesn't make a bad instrumental, I guess. I sort of was winging that a little bit there, and it seemed like it came out relatively okay, so could pursue that a little. I'm playing a lot of things with a capo lately. For Sounds of Silence, I usually put it at the 5th fret, even though they did it at the 6th. It's just the 5th fret is a better spot. Been playing a lot of things capoed lately, and not to leak too much, got a couple of really big things that I've been telling you about for weeks just around the corner as we as everything gets unlocked here. Totally TG has sort of been locked down too for not much longer, but just because something big it's about to change. We're about to have everything loosened up. And I want to thank everybody, first of all, for the patience in like not a whole lot of new stuff going on for much of a long time. But that's not much longer. What else is other cool capo songs? There's, of course, these. What was that? little bit of Angie, a little bit of 16 tons. Not too much of Angie, but just stolen the licks from it. So let's see. I don't think I have any other big news. I got some lessons coming up. I've been doing a lot of Skype lessons. Well, more of a Zoom, but boy, it's been really fun to reconnect with some of the distant TGers and you know, scheduling some lessons with people that are well known on our forum. It's really cool. So, okay, I think that is really it for today's thing. I want to keep this just kind of short and hope to have a lot of bigger stuff next week. By next Friday, some of these things should see the light of day. Who knows? Probably not. Okay, all those biggies that I've been threatening to do lessons on. Are coming, I promise. I still promise. Wait, don't promise anything. Funny story about Jose Feliciano, but I can't remember what it is now. Somebody I spoke to was doing a repair at his house, like in Irvine or Orange County someplace. And anyway, he was thrilled to walk in and fix his water heater or something like that. And he just saw Jose's guitar sitting in the corner. And Jose asked him, he said, "Hey, you see my guitar over there?" He goes, "Yeah." He goes, "Well, I don't." Okay. See you next week.